Hello, my comic book loving sons of bitches, and hopefully the ladies that might have clicked on this video thinking, hey, I want to see a handsome fat guy with a speech impediment. So, welcome to another comic book haul. We got some really lovely comics to show off, as well as a few little pots. Yay. This haul was purchased on May 21st, 2016. The weekend before X-Men Apocalypse, and a few days before DC's Rebirth. Yay. Are you excited? Seriously, down in the comments, let me know if you're excited for DC's Rebirth. I can't really say I'm excited. I'm intrigued, but I can't say I'm really excited because I've kind of lost track with my DC comics. We get them, my sister and I, we buy them, we collect them. I have not actually read any DC comics in a while, because I'm still catching up with all the Marvel stuff that I'm, you know, backed up on. Including, yes, goddammit, Secret Wars. I need to finish that series. I am very close to finishing everything with that series. Then I'm gonna jump on to some of the older DC stuff that I need to catch up on, and then we'll worry about Rebirth after that. Of course, naturally, I am excited to start collecting what they have to offer, but I can't necessarily say I'm excited as a fan because I'm not really caught up on, you know, what DC has right now. I'm not sure what the stories are for the last of the new 52 series. So, you know, I'm excited to collect them, but I have to, you know, I still have a long way before I have to read them. So, as I said, we got some comics to show you, some collectibles. So, let's go ahead and get into it. As always, if you would like to follow me on Instagram, you can see all of my haul picks. And this actually an exclusive pick you might want to check out. During the week, recently I did a special order haul from comics that we ordered from Midtown Comics. 3 more came in a couple of days after I did that video. My sister did she ordered the first issue of Titan Comics. But she ordered, Penny Dreadful, issue number 1. And she ordered a couple of variants to go with it. So if you want to check those covers out, you can go on my Instagram or you can just Google them, to be honest. But if you want to see the ones that I got, go ahead and go on my Instagram. You can check out the pic that's on Google, on my Instagram, at StuffBurritoENT. I think I've rambled on enough. Let's get into the comics. And funny enough, both bags are identical from Bag and Board and Under City. And that's simply because everybody's trying to promote not only Rebirth, but Creature, the new AMC series. So that's pretty cool. So yeah, this is the Bag and Board haul. Show you the Under City home just a little bit. So let's go ahead and, you know what, I should have organized these because some of these I'd like to show in a certain order. I did not organize them. I should have organized them. Damn it. Look at me, I'm organizing them as I talk to you. That's pretty messed up, right? Alright, so let's go ahead and get into it. First, for DC's, I don't know if this is the, oh yeah, it does, it says the final days of Superman. This is issue number 29 of Superman and Wonder Woman. You know what, I put the camera way too far. I'm just realizing that right now, I put the camera way too far. So hopefully, I'm speaking loudly and clearly enough. I know everybody has a problem with my voice anyway. Next, we have the final Wonder Woman for this current series. We have issue number 52 of Wonder Woman. That's a pretty cool pick right there. Very simple, very, very nice. I don't like putting them on my chair because they bend. Next, we have number 6. And I believe, I looked it up recently, I think this is an 8-part series, so we're almost at the end. Number 6 of The Legend of Wonder... You can see it right there. I don't know what happened. The Legend of Wonder Woman, pretty cool cover. Next we have number 8 of Titans Hunt. Really cool cover right there. Yeah, I put the camera... Not only did I put the camera too far, but I put it too close to the lamp, so I'm getting glare from the lamp. Good job. Hopefully you guys can see these clearly. Number 10 of Injustice, Year 5. I believe that Year 5, yeah? Yeah. Doomsday Scenario. Nice. And then we jump on the Marvel side. Yeah, here we go. Actually, I'm looking at my stack, and I don't have a whole lot of Marvel this week. I do have some back issues that I'm going to show you, really cool stuff, but not a lot of new Marvel comics from Dragon Board. But we do have the big one, the most anticipated one, Civil War 2, Issue 0. I can't wait to read this, but like I said, I'm still reading Secret Wars. Let me just tell you, last night I read issues 7 and 8 of Secret Wars, and I loved them. So I only have issue number 9 to read, but I'm going to actually cut it off from there. I'm going to jump on to Thor's and Ultimate End. Those are the last two tie-ins I have to read. So after that, then I'm going to read issue number 9. I don't remember if I said on an earlier video that I was actually going to watch or read those two tie-ins and then 7, 8, 9. But I figure since the Thors are so crucial to the core story, and since there's a lot of developments happening, and Thor's number 5 was one of the last tie-ins to actually come out, I want to make sure that I don't spoil anything as far as the story goes, because, you know, I don't want the effects of the core story to affect the Thor's story. I don't know if they do, I don't know if they don't, but just to be on the safe side, I'm catching up on, you know, I'm going to read the tie-ins and then finish it off with issue number 9, which is how it should be. That was the last Secret Wars comic to come out. So next we have issue number 8 of All New Wolverine. And of course this is tied in with the road to Civil War 2. And this also has the beginning of a new story arc. I definitely want to jump on this. I want to read this comic. But I want to go back and look for my sister's Death of Wolverine comics and read those, and then kind of lean into All New Wolverine. And of course, Old Man Logan. Next, we have issue number 9 of The Uncanny X-Men. So, pretty cool. We got some Deadpool on there. We got, I believe that's Rogue. Johnny Storm, I would assume. Once again, I'm not reading this yet, but I'm getting there. I'm gonna get there. Okay, next was actually a free comic, and in I guess celebration and with the promotion of the show Preacher, AMC's Preacher coming out, they're giving away free comics of Preacher, and I'm assuming that this is, you know, maybe part of the I don't know if it's tied into the actual episode or if it is a comic book version of the first episode, so I don't know, but it looks pretty cool. I kind of dig the way they do the artistry, kind of, you know, They don't necessarily put a lot of color into it. Very simple. Yeah, I'm looking forward to checking this out, and as well as the show. I'm very excited to see the show because I really like Dominic Cooper. I think he's a really good actor. So next we have Thor Back Issues, and three of these, in my opinion, are really, well, actually all of them. They're all really good finds, and one of them was on full display. It was on the top shelf of that bagging board, and my sister couldn't resist. This is one of her favorite images with these two characters. And the funny thing is, as I look at it, I can't help but think we have this. But maybe not. I don't know. Anyway, we have a back issue of number 12, Justice League, with the famous Superman, Wonder Woman embracing, and as you can see, it says it's a first print. So, this is definitely going to stay sealed. Next we have, these look cool. We were digging through the island and we found these. My sister actually found these. I really like the covers and I want to check them out. Maybe I'll read them and hopefully I can track down the rest of these. But, I'm not sure what year these came out on. But we have issue number 1 of the Winter Soldier. Winter Soldier, it's just called Winter Soldier. The one I collected from last year was Bucky Barnes, the Winter Soldier. And that was cool. That with outer space stuff. Here's issue number 2, by the way. Really awesome color. I'm kind of hoping that it looks, from the looks of these colors, I'm hoping that this takes place on Earth and we actually get more, you know, actual combat as opposed to space stuff. I never actually finished that series. I was reading it for a while, then I got kind of bored. I'll go back to it eventually, but this definitely looks more of what I enjoy from this character. And then lastly, over at Bagging Board, this was a great find, in my opinion. This is something that you just don't see very often. And, well, if you do, if you see it at your local comic book shop, let me know. But either way, I'm happy that I found this. I'm not sure what kind of condition it's in. It looks like it's in fairly good condition, but we have a nice vintage comic, issue number 1, of Blade Runner. How dope is that? Blade Runner in a comic book. This is an oldie but goodie, man. This still has the Spider-Man logo on the cover. And, yeah, look at that. Just look at that awesome vintage, you know, comic book art, comic book styles. This was 60 cents. Do you see that shit? 60 cents. That's how much comics cost back in the 80s. But anyway, this is really cool. Only paid, it's $3.99, it's labeled $3.99, but of course they always give you a discount over at Bagging Board if you're a regular. But this is really cool. I'm very pleased to have found this. Alright, so next let's move on to the Undercity Hall, and we almost didn't walk away with too much, but we found some good stuff. We found some pretty good comics that we usually get. We have issue number 3 of International Iron Man. Really hope this is a good series. Really do, because I'm collecting it, and I'm not reading it. So next we have issue number 11 of Deadpool. Very happy to have found this because this actually came out last week and they didn't put it aside for me, but I found it this week, so I'm very happy. This one I almost got paranoid because Dragon Ball didn't save it for me, and they're usually really good with saving this comic, but they didn't do it this time. It's okay, I don't complain. It's, you know, things happen. So anyway, we have issue number 7 of Spider-Woman. as well as part 7 for Spider-Woman, the crossover event. So I'm missing at least 2 issues from this spin-off, this crossover. So I gotta find those and then I'll be very happy. Next we have I hope this is good. I just recently started collecting this, I don't even know why. But we have issue number 12 of Robin, Son of Batman, Fighting Some Dinosaurs. This I was also very happy. This came out last week. I guess they said that they had a shortage from last week. But they replenished their inventory and I was able to get Black Widow number 3. Awesome. Next is, this is actually my sister's stuff. Let me show this off first. We have Buffy the Vampire Slayer number 27. And this is season number, I honestly can't see that. Number 10. Because we have the regular edition and we have the variant. So, good stuff. Yeah, okay. Good old Buffy. Next we have, that's crazy how they come out with these multiple editions for these comics that really I doubt anybody's ever heard of. But anyway, we have issue 3 of 5 from Zenoscope. We have Hail Child. This is cover A. Cover B. This is actually really cool. I like this cover. Problem Children. Nice. So cover B. And this is kind of kinky. Here's cover C. Alright. And lastly, very happy, I think I rambled about this in the last video, last week's haul. Not the special order video, but the haul, the actual haul. They pulled aside a really good variant for me, but when it comes to Star Wars, I need the standard edition. Luckily, they had this, was the only one they had. So, very happy about that. We have issue number 20 of Star Wars Darth Vader. This is the start of a new story and of games. But anyway, very happy to have this. You got the Emperor lurking in the background. You got his little red guards. Such an idiot. Some Star Wars fan I am. I forget what they call these guys. Very happy to have found that. Alright, so we have some Funkos and a Big Thing character. Now, we did not get these at the comic store. We actually found this shit at Walmart. My sister and I, we don't like Walmart. But we went there looking for something specific. Ended up coming out with a bunch of other stuff that we didn't need, but, I mean, no. We needed these. We need this shit. So, we got some Funkos and a Big Thing. So I spotted this right away and I was just it's open. Oh, that's not cool. Fucking Walmart. Oh man. It's okay. Everything is intact. Everything is fine. It just, it was open. The box isn't even damaged. It's just, it opened a little bit. But I spotted this right away, and I was very happy, because I didn't even know that they had made a Funko for this character. But we have Agent 13 from Captain America Civil War. This is great. I'm intrigued with this character. I hope they continue to develop her in the films. I hope she remains part of the MCU, and she appears in various films. The actress who plays her is very pretty. And, she's Peggy Carter's niece, so that's actually a spoiler. But I'm sure you saw Civil War by now, even though, I if you know your comics, you already know that. But anyway, Agent 13, very happy that I found this. She's really adorable, and I'm so happy to have her in my life, since I don't have a real girlfriend. Anyway, next, I showed my sister this, she couldn't resist. We have Ron Weasley from the Harry Potter series. This is really cool. Oh yeah. And finally for the Funko Pops, how the hell do you make he who should not be named look cute? You put him in a Funko Pop. Nice. Lord V. I don't want to say his name. I don't want to say Lord Voldemort. I said it. He's gonna come kill us all. Lord Voldemort. That's it. It's really cute. Hey, you're good. And finally, just because we just couldn't resist, and we actually have... Well, let me show you what we got first. Oh, Batman. Big Fig. I love the detailing on this. This is insane. This is really, really cool. How has 19 inches, that's pretty equivalent to what I, no, it's not. But dude, this is awesome. Look at it, looks like Ben Affleck, dude. That's awesome. But the detailing is really, really cool. I mean, I totally dig it. And we actually do have the Wonder Woman one. No, I never actually showed it off in this video, and I didn't actually take a picture of it, but we do have it, so, you know, all you gotta do is look it up online, you'll see what it looks like, but we do have it. We got Batman today. We're probably gonna have to order, Superman, because we can't find them anywhere, but we saw this at Walmart, and we were blown away on how well detailed it was. And since we had Wonder Woman already, figured, hey, gotta have the bats. Matter of fact, let's not even get Superman. Let's just put Wonder Woman and Batman together. This shit is pure fan fiction, man. It's all about Wonder Woman and Batman. Come on. Alright guys, so that's it. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed what I showed you. Got any questions, or if you just want to talk comics, or please tell me what you got. If you have a comic book haul video, link it down below. Or if you have an Instagram where you got a bunch of comic stuff, send me the link. I don't care. I love following everybody who collects the stuff that I do. And yeah, anything you want to talk about, once again, if, you know, what are your thoughts on DC's rebirth? Are you anticipating Civil War 2, the new comic coming out? And yeah, thank you for watching. As I said already, please like this video. That would really make me feel so special. And I'll see you guys next week. Thank you for watching. That is 3 times I said that. I'm gonna go now. Never let anybody tell you too old to collect comic books, because if they do, those people are just... They're so lame. They're so lame. I don't like them. Alright guys, peace out.